retired superintendent. At the outset, I am extremely delighted to be here, even though I am not a Muslim. In the Old Testament of the Bible, it is noted as that God created the day and night in the first day. After that, God created the sun and the moon. How is it possible for the day and night without the sun? Likewise, in Quran, it is mentioned that the sun rotates the earth. As per chapter 21, verse 22 of Quran, God controls the universe. My doubt is as to whether God had mistaken when he creates the universe. I think the contents in the Bible and the Quran are against the science. Please explain.
Brother, can I have your name? And can you repeat what is about the Quran? I didn't hear correctly. Your name first. And what do you mention about the Quran? Quran says that the sun
Quran
rotates.
In Surah number 6, I think.
Quran number 6, the sun rotates. You said 21, 22. Chapter 21, verse 22.
Chapter number 21, verse 22. 22.
The sun rotates.
No. In Surah number 6, I think. But in chapter 21, verse 22, God controls the universe.
So that goes against science, according to
you. Yes.
Brother asked a question. He said that he has read the Bible. He quoted a few verses of the Bible and of the Quran, didn't give the reference. He said that the Bible says that Almighty God created day and the night in the first day. What he's quoting is the first book of the Bible, the book of Genesis, chapter number 1, verse number 3. It says that Almighty God created the day and the night and on the first day. And further, if you read in Genesis chapter number 1, verse number 13 to 19, it says Almighty God created the sun on the fourth day. I'm giving the references also. So doesn't this go against science? I do agree with you, it goes against science. And I had a debate with Dr. William Campbell in USA. Dr. William Campbell, he is a missionary and a medical doctor and got a PhD in writing a book against the Quran. And in that debate on the Quran and the Bible in the light of science, even I posed this question, even he couldn't answer. So I do agree there's a problem in the Bible. Now coming to your question, that the Quran says that Almighty God controls the universe. Regarding the Bible, yes, I do agree with you, Bible is against established science. Regarding a question that Quran says Almighty God controls the universe, you didn't say that sun rotates. That's what I heard. Therefore, I'm asking you to repeat. Why are you repeating? I heard that. And it gave reference, chapter 21, verse 22, the reference is wrong. The real reference is Surah Anbiya, chapter 21, verse 33, not 22. Verse 33. Here's the Quran. I'm speaking from memory. I'm not a computer. I'll give the reply, brother. After I reply, whatever query you have, no problem, brother. You ask the question, let me reply. After I finish my reply, you can ask another 20 questions. But you ask the question, I was listening to you carefully. Now you listen to my answer. And after I finish my answer, if you have any query you can ask, I will give you enough time. If chairman doesn't agree, I'll request him to give you time because you are delighted to come here. We are more delighted that you are here. The brother said that the Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter 21, verse 22, it's actually verse 33, that the sun rotates. What he's quoting is the verse of the Quran of Surah Anbiya, chapter 21, verse 33, which says, "Huwal lazi khalaqal layl wa nahara." It is Allah who has created night and the day. Washamsa wal kamar, sun and the moon. Kullun fi falaki yasbahun, each one traveling in orbit with his own motion. And this mistake was even taken out by Taslima Nasreen. You know Taslima Nasreen? Heard of her? From Bangladesh. She said that if a book believe that the sun rotates around the earth, then how can we advance? So the Quran has to be changed. Nauz billah. The problem is that a view should be changed and she should read the Quran correctly. The Quran says, "Huwa allazi khalaqal layla wan nahara." It is Allah who has created the night and the day. Washamsa wal qamar, the sun and the moon. Kullun fi falaki yasbahun, each one traveling in orbit with its own motion. Nowhere does the Quran say that the sun rotates or revolves around the earth. Nowhere. What does the Quran say? The sun and the moon rotate and revolve. Nowhere does it say around the earth. The word earth is not there in this verse. It says, "Huwa allazi khalaqal layla wan nahara." It is Allah who has created night and day. Washamsa wal qamar, the sun and the moon. Kullun fi falaki yasbahun, each one traveling in orbit with its own motion. When I was in school, I had learned that the sun was stationary. It did not rotate about its own axis. It revolved in the universe. Though solar system is revolving, but when I passed my school in 1982, I had learned the sun was stationary, did not rotate. But this verse of the Quran says the Arabic word yasbuhun is derived from the word sabaha, which describes the motion of a moving body. If I use this Arabic word sabaha for a person on the floor, it will not mean he's rolling, it will mean he's walking or running. If I use this Arabic word for a person in the water, it will not mean he's floating, it will mean he's swimming. When Allah uses this word for a celestial body, it doesn't mean it's flying, it means it is rotating about its own axis. So Quran says the sun and the moon, besides revolving, they're also rotating about their own axis. When I read the verse of the Quran, I said, but I read in my school book, the sun does not rotate. Today science has advanced and we come to know we can have the image of the sun on a tabletop. And we see that the sun has got black spots. And these black spots take about 25 days to complete one rotation, indicating the sun takes approximately 25 days to complete one rotation. So what I learned in school in 1982, today science says it is wrong. Quran has mentioned this not 20 years back, 1400 years back. What I learned in school 20 years back. The Quran says, what I learned is wrong. First I got a shock. But then when I did more research, I realized that the Quran is right. Quran is not wrong. My science book was wrong. And Taslima Nasreen, where did she put the word earth inside? I don't know. Does she know Arabic? Can she read English? English translation doesn't say that. She assumed that when the Quran says the sun revolves, it revolves around the earth. That's her assumption. So her assumption is wrong. Alhamdulillah, Quran is not wrong. And I do agree with you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he controls this universe. That's the reason, according to Francis Bacon, the great philosopher, he said, little knowledge of science makes you an atheist, but in-depth knowledge of science makes you a believer in one God. Hope that answers the question.
Do you have another question?
If you have any question,
brother,
you're most welcome. If you have any counter question, you're most welcome, brother. We love you.
Sir, I'm not sure the chapter number.
No problem. I never criticize you. I just corrected you.
I have to just tell
the right thing. If you have given something wrong reference, if someone opened, I corrected you. I didn't say that you have to know by heart. Neither are you a computer, neither am I a computer.
But I think it is in the surah number 8. I think the sun is rotating earth.
It's nowhere in the Quran. I'm telling you, the verse you're quoting is Surah Anbiya, chapter 21, verse 33, even quoted by Taslima Nasreen and hundreds of critics of Islam. Nowhere in Surah Anfal chapter 8 does it say that the sun, nowhere in the Quran it says the sun rotates. The closest misunderstanding you can have, if you don't know Arabic or don't read the translation correctly, is Surah Anbiya. So your first reference was very close, only 11 verses difference. So your reference was right, chapter number was right, 21. But the verse was not 22, it was verse 33. Yes, the Quran.
No. Chapter number 21, verse 22. The God controls the universe.
Acha, now one more. The God controls the universe. That's what I'm telling you. Science hasn't advanced so far to come to know about the reality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've given the talk, is the Quran God's word? And I've proved scientifically the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I would request one of the volunteers to present my video cassette to him. I request Brother Ashraf that you can ask one of the volunteers. I'll give you a gift, a video cassette. Is the Quran God's word, which has mentioned several scientific facts and has even proved scientifically the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, today scientists, top scientists are not eliminating God. They are not the eliminating models of God. La ilaha. They are not eliminating God, but eliminating models of God. La ilaha illallah. You understand? So today scientists, top scientists in the world, they all believe in God. Most, some may have deviated, but most of them agree there has to be a creator about the creation of the universe. Today science tells us, how did the universe come into creation? How? By the Big Bang, correct?
Yes,
very good. Big Bang. That today scientists tell us that first there was a primary nebula, the whole universe, then there was secondary separation, a Big Bang, which gave rise to galaxies, which gave rise to stars, the planets, the sun, the moon, and the earth we live in. This is called the Big Bang. When did you come to know about this Big Bang? 20 years back, 30 years back, 40 years back, correct? Allah says in the Quran in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 30, Allah says 1400 years ago, Allah says that do not the unbelievers see that the heavens and the earth were joined together. Do not the unbelievers see anna samawati wal arda, that the heavens and the earth were joined together and we clove them asunder. So Allah says that the heavens and the earth were joined together and we clove them asunder. This Big Bang, what today the scientists talk about, is mentioned in the Quran 1400 years back in a nutshell. Who could have mentioned this? That time science wasn't advanced. Who? The creator. So like that, I've given a full talk. You can refer to my video cassette of Quran Modern Science, and is the Quran God's word. Inshallah, inshallah, if you watch it with an open mind, you have to be convinced that there's one God and he is the creator of the universe.
Thank you.